Sure, why not?
You're so sane.
No. Lost now?
Nice work, Pete.
Long song, is that okay?
No.
I wonder if they can see Pokemon. Do you think they can see Pokemon?
Yes.
You can. Okay.
Well, before we begin, for those who don't know, this is Luke Raymond and Stephen Murray. All right? We're here to congratulate them, but before we begin, let's just give the Lord praise real quick. Shall we? No, y'all can leave it up.
Okay.
I think the Lord will understand. Your body pins may not come out. Father God, we come before you. We say thank you for the day, the graces that you've shown these two gentlemen, and Father, the ability to have friends and fellowship, Christian bonding, Father. We thank you for this. Father, I just want to bestow that these two gentlemen, Father, as they step into adulthood, that you will direct their paths. That you will lead them into a way that will be extraordinarily glorifying to you, Father. That you will take them on paths that can only be you, God. And we do thank you for the time. We thank you for Kimberly for the time she's put forth in coming over here on a daily basis and teaching these boys. And Father, I just pray that whatever future it is for her as well, God, that you will just glorify yourself in, through her. We thank you for all this in your son Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Go ahead and sit down on your stupid chairs.
My kind of color.
Oh, wait a minute. Can I please have you all stand?
Oh, okay.
Just stand right there. Dearly beloved, we're gathered here today to...
I do. It's over.
Well, this is my time. And... Stephen, you're going to have to sit tight and listen to what I have to say for my son. Y'all may sit down, by the way.
Thank you.
No, you're welcome.
Be seated.
And, you know, 18 years ago, we were anticipating Luke's arrival in our family.
Was it 19 years ago?
Okay, you're fixing to finish your 18th year. All right. But we were anticipating your arrival. And let me just tell you that your arrival was an extraordinary event in our life, and we glorify God for that. And Luke, through the years, you've overcome difficulties. You're the disabilities that were recognized in your learning, and you overcame those areas. And you've done an extraordinary job. You've grown into a young man who is able to put his hands to the work, and you've done a great job at that. And I hope that whatever you've learned in this little schoolhouse in the Polokwane will be one that will be carrying on with you for years. And we thank you for the hard work you put in, especially this year. You graduated a year in advance. You put in 2 years of hard work into 1 year. That's an accomplishment in itself. And you've done a great job. I know in the next year you'll be moving on back to the States, and it's kind of heartbreaking for your mother and I, but at the same time, we know that we're entrusting God to direct you and to lead you and take care of you, just like he has entrusted us to raise you. You've done a great job being our young son. Now you're a graduate from the, well, it was just the Rayleigh Academy, and then it became the Rayleigh Hickson Academy, now it's the Rayleigh Murray Academy. And for Kimberly, thank you. My personal thank you to you for all the hard work and dedication, sacrifice. For somebody who went through a university to become a teacher, never set foot in the classroom, but to come overseas to focus on my son. Thank you very much. And I want to hand it over to the Murrays, and then
be a long one, guys. I need to read my speech. So I hope I can be as concise and still do justice to the other young man. Stephen, as our firstborn, he's also a millennium baby. And then more recently, Stephen's been our outhouse occupier there in the Makuku, in the Marae backyard. It's been a joy, son, to see you grow up, especially see you grow up following the Lord. And as our oldest, that's just been such an encouragement for us, your parents, and knowing that that your siblings, the rest of our kids, have a godly and an honorable old Obud in whose footsteps to follow. So thank you for setting that standard, son. I just want to briefly read this from Proverbs 2. The beginning here is a bit abbreviated. Son, as wise King Solomon said, treasure the commands of the Lord, search for wisdom, insight, and understanding. Then you'll understand what it means to fear the Lord. For the Lord grants wisdom. He grants the treasure of common sense to the honest. He is a shield to those who walk with integrity. He guards the path of the just and protects those who are faithful to him. Then you will understand what is right, just, and fair, and you will find the right way to go. So on this occasion of you guys finishing this chapter of school and kidhood, we are looking forward to watching both of you in the road ahead, and it's with great anticipation and expectation, but also I think peace of mind knowing that you guys follow the Lord. And today I also think with a very warm heart of Noah as well, considering that you three musketeers shared so much times and friendship here in Polokwane, and we really thankful to the Lord for the friends that he's given you and the circumstances that that he set in who our friends and your friends became, in the neighborhood where we're living and everything else. And if I think of my prior running away from Polokwane, a place I'm not always all that fond of, thinking that 6-7 years ago the Lord brought us right back here, that wasn't necessarily where your dad wanted to be. And I can definitely see that if for no other reason, the Lord definitely had you in mind when he brought us back. Because these last 7 years have been, well, your mom and I have just seen the phenomenal goodness, faithfulness, and nurturing of the Lord in providing the friends and the circumstances that have just seen you grow up. And we're very proud of you, son. I want to a very special word of thanks to Kim and to Nathan. Guys, we really appreciate what you have given and sacrificed and done. Both of you individually, as a teacher and as a youth pastor and mentor for this son of ours, and the fruit is showing. So thank you so much. We really appreciate you guys for that. And then everyone else who is here, you all as special in that these different families here and Debbie over there, you've all played a significant role in Stephen's life and in Luke's life, and we're just so thankful to the Lord for that, and we cherish you as friends and as people who have come around, stood up around with us to raise these young men to honor the Lord. So thank you very much. Vaughns, Hicksons, Rayleighs, Storses, Debbie, Granny, Lenny, we love you all. And Steve, we wish you both a wonderful adulthood. And we know you are following the Lord, so the worry and the stress is off us as parents, because we know we can entrust you to the Lord and you know him and will follow him. It's a great day. Congratulations to us both. May I shake your hands? In front of you.
into. Please come up here.
Oh boy, I'm getting old, man.
Let me give the honors.
Shall I?
Thank you. If you would just stay right there for a second. Just kind of have everybody just kind of gather around, and we're just gonna pray over these two guys, man. Just as friends, family, and stuff. Unless you're holding the camera. Brad, I'm just gonna ask you just prayer.
Heavenly Father, we just we thank you for these two men and what you've done in their life through the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you that you brought them to this time in their life, that you've helped them to persevere, to by your grace give them the ability to learn and to have understanding in school, Father. And as Marius and had spoken, Father, that these are your children, grafted with Christ, and will be forever brothers to him. And so we trust you as you lead them throughout their life, Father. We pray that you would give them wisdom, Father, that you would that they would seek after you in all things, and Father, that you would bless them and keep them. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Congratulations, gentlemen.